This is Kyle Green Underbridge. The purpose of the structure is to carry the HS2 trace over the West Coast mainline. So far we have completed all of the rotary board piles for both the underbridge and the retaining walls, as well as all of our abutment walls, pile caps for both the retaining walls and the structure. Our retaining walls are currently undergoing. We're due to complete them this year. The big milestone that we've had is that we've successfully completed the installation of 83 number inverted T-beams, 81 of them being the standard size, and then two specials, which are the edge beams. As you can see, the hoarding on the end of them, that allows us to then come in during the day and fix reinforcement and GRP panels. These T-beams were installed during rules of the route possession, where the network rail infrastructure is off, there's no trains running, and all the overhead line equipment has been turned off and isolated. So the beams are installed using a crawler crane offline, and they're lifted into a position and engineered to sit on the bridge bearings, which are on the abutment walls. So we need to install the scaffold access to allow us to access the area on top of the deck, and then further pour the deck and the ancillary civils like the robust curb and noise barriers, etc. The main challenge is the network rail infrastructure. With the structure being 4 metres away from the network rail boundary fence, we've had to do a lot of works on nights. For example, do all lifting next to the railway on nights. And we then had to incorporate a specialist gantry system, which allowed us to install reinforcement and pour the abutment walls during the days using this rolling gantry system. The wing walls are different shapes. The idea behind that is to use less carbon, so less reinforcement, less concrete. These tapering wing walls then take into account the backfill material that's going to be adjacent to it and how it falls away from the structure. Once the structure is complete, HS2 will travel across the structure, but in the interim, prior to us getting to that stage, we'll use it as a haul road to significantly reduce the amount of haulage vehicles on local roads by taking materials from the south to the north. I started HS2 in June 2021, and I'm extremely proud and I'm excited to see the completion of the bridge and stand on the bridge deck once it's done.